Hey guys, it's Harrison and Joanna with Last Chance Pets. We're here in Woodsfield, Ohio, where it all started for us, the whole inspiration for this show. At Vicky Grows Rescue, she does amazing work that 99.9% of the rest of the world is not willing to do. You know, Vicky's one of those people that has dedicated her life, her and her husband. This is what they do. They live for it every day.
As you can see behind us, she went through a horrible, horrible fire.
They lost their beautiful home. Dottie is one of the survivors of the fire here at Vicky's, and she's got an amazing story, and you're not going to believe it, but it's very inspirational.
Dottie went to a pet store, a national chain pet store. Since they make supposed guarantees on the dogs have to be quote-unquote perfect to be sold there. In Dottie's case, it was demodeptic mange, which is from the parents. It's inherited. It's genetic. We also found out she had entropion, she had cherry eyes. So she had 3 eye surgeries, and we got her spayed, and she was all ready for adoption. Dottie was just, she's a cool dog. Yeah. She was just funny and great. And all those dogs are like that. They just need out of there. They just need a chance. Mm-hmm. Every one of them.
She just really has a heart to help. You know, it's not just the sheer numbers. It's not just rescuing numbers. She takes the ones that nobody else wants to deal with. There's a lot of work with puppy mills, and she tries to take a bad situation and make it good. You know, she'll bring me the crippled up ones that somebody else would have euthanized and gives them a chance. And, you know, surprisingly, most of them do very well. They may have a little limp, but they're significantly improved, and their quality of life is very improved from what it would have been.
But after we got there fixed up, Dottie was running around here, terrorizing everybody and just being a ball. Just a goofy bulldog, happy-go-lucky. Anybody can like a puppy. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? These dogs take a little more time, a little more devotion, a little more work, but you get so much more out of them.
Right.
Because these dogs are devotion beyond belief. Our house wasn't just like you went out and bought a house and moved in it. It was nothing like that. Because it was ours. We built it there. We got married there. It was our house. It was really our house. When I opened up the door from the kitchen out into the room where the dogs could run in and out, they had like a doggy door, I could see the flames coming around the sliding glass doors. And I thought, for a minute, you just think it can't be real. I'm not leaving my dogs.
I knew she wouldn't leave them dogs in the house.
I went and got the first load of dogs and threw them out the front door because I thought, oh my God, let's get them out here. So I threw them out into this fence because this whole front yard's fenced in. And then I started throwing them out the side door because this used to be really pretty. It used to have like a set of French doors off of our living room. And it went down to like 3 little octagon porches. And I just started throwing them all out there. You shoulda, coulda, woulda all the time. What if I'd have done this and maybe I should have done that? But I did everything I could. And honest to God, no joke, I'd rather die than let anything happen to any of them. I really would have. Because now I have to live with that the rest of my life. Think about it every day. Dottie looked like a toasted marshmallow because she was white with all the singed brown hair and it just toasted her brown. Dottie, you know, was kind of coffee from the smoke. And I said, please, I don't want to take any chances. She's a bulldog, the smoke, just please take her to Denise. So my cousin drove 2.5 hours up to Denise and took Dottie up for me because she knew she said, what can I do? And I said, that's what you can do. Take Dottie to Denise.
And I knew that Dottie was a white dog and she was carrying this brown dog. And you know, for a minute I thought, wow, that's not Dottie, it's one of the other dogs, but it was Dottie. Her hair was completely singed off, and a good thing is she didn't have terrible smoke inhalation. That seems to be the worst part. Couldn't really tell how severe her wounds were. She actually was in pretty good spirits that night, washed her off and started on some medication.
Dr. Baldick is the most incredible person in the world. It just takes somebody who's got a heart for animals to help us.
You know, as time went on, we could see the patches of skin that were obviously dead and dry, and it took 2 to 3 weeks really for that dead skin that was burned to start peeling off. Every day we would just sort of watch and see. Once all that was off, we could see what a large portion of her body was burned.
Burns like that are not something you can recreate. know what I mean? You can't take a dog and burn it and then figure out how to fix it. Right. You know what I mean? So this just has to be a unfortunate situation that a dog got in, and luckily she's, you know, willing to say, I'll try it. You know, and thank God for vets, you know, who like do that. Care, who wanna step up and go out of the safety zone of spay neuter shots warming.
When we finally got her healed enough, we did some skin grafts, and that was my first skin graft, and it worked out really well. She was here a total of, I think, 63 days.
Everybody wants to supposedly rescue a dog, but it has to be perfect.
Yeah.
Right.
The dog has to be perfect, can't have any issues. Well, then it's not really much of a rescue now, is it? You know what I mean? And I appreciate the fact, and I understand they think of thousands and thousands of dollars of the vet bills. Normally it's not that. I mean, because usually all the vetting is taken care of before they ever leave here. Really, all I need you to do is give them a good, loving, permanent home, because I can't do them all. And I always have, when that dog goes on, I have another one that needs it. Dottie had a home before the fire, and then we were lucky enough that after the fire, she said, I don't care, I still want her. And we're like, because a lot of people.
I'm sure you don't get that a lot.
No. And she has a friend who's a nurse in a burn ward for children. And now they're going to take Dottie there and do therapy work.
Yeah.
And take Dottie in and let the other kids see. The cool
Dottie.
Thing about dogs is Dottie has no clue that she's burned.
Yeah.
Dottie has no clue that she has scars. So therefore, she doesn't let it affect her. That can show the children, look, Dottie's fine. You know, you see Dottie for the fun, happy-go-lucky goofball that she is.
For me, she encompasses kind of the whole thing of what you're doing, of taking these dogs that probably would have been euthanized, and then you look at the scope of just taking her single case of how many lives that's going to affect, even for the vet. I mean, the trickle down of all that, of now she's got a pretty drastic skin graft under her belt, so now she can treat that on some of these other pets where she may have not done that in the past. Mm-hmm. She's got some experience.
Mm-hmm.
She's still a young dog, and it's going to have a lot of years where, you know, not only the kids in the burn ward, but the people that work there, the nurses, and all that inspiration. I mean, it's amazing to see what one animal can do through its life.
You're an angel to the animal.
Yeah, for sure.
You're like the Mother Teresa of the animals.
I'm just somebody who likes a dog and just think they all deserve a chance.